Hello po sa lahat. Ngayong araw na to, ang pag-uusapan natin ay tungkol sa natanggap ko na envelope galing sa SBRCG ng Philippine Embassy dito sa Spain.
So, this is the Special Ballot Reception and Custody Group. Actually, I changed the address. I sent an email to voters overseas to change the address from Barcelona to our new address. Nag-ask lang sila ng Filipino passport and dual documents ko dito sa Spain. Actually, nareceive ko to sa postal box namin. So, ganito na to siya. Naka-open na siya. Let's open kung ano ang laman nito. Ito yung plastic para... So, ito yung the special ballot reception. May national and local election paper seal. After mo ma-fill out ang form na to, kung ano yung, sino yung pipiliin mo na mga kandidato, so I already did my own research sa mga tumatakbo na mga kandidato. So I don't want to influence myself sa mga kaibigan ko or sa post ng sa Facebook. I will vote according to what I research. So ito yung laman. So, ito yung from president, vice president, as senators. Tapos, sa likod dito, yung party list. Actually, ilan lang yung kilala ko na party list. I-fill out ko to mamaya, pag may time ako, may libreng time. For now, let's spend our time with our family. And on Monday, after sa work ko, I think I will pass by and drop this. So, at ito naman, ito yung how to send your vote by mail. Check the contents of your postal voting ticket. It should contain a ballot envelope addressed to SBRCG, an official ballot automated, a paper seal, and this instructional guide. So, ito yung postal voting packet. Ballot envelope. This one is the ballot envelope addressed to SBRCG, which is the Special Ballot Reception and Custody Group. Ito yung address dito sa Embahada ng Republika de Filipinas sa Madrid. So, ito yung at saka yung paper seal. So, second step, using a black ball pen or sign pen, fully shade the circle inside the candidates of your choice. Do not use highlighters, pencils, or light colored pens to shade the ovals. Step 3, you can vote one candidate for president, one vice president, up to 12 for senators, and one party list group. If you vote for more than allowed number of candidates per position, your vote will not be counted for that position. So you have to be careful on filling out this form. So, before po kayo mag-fill out sa form, kailangan basahin mo yung instructional guide at kailangan intindihin ng mabuti. Step 4, do not put any other marks on the ballot, especially on the timing marks, and place the accomplished ballot inside the ballot envelope addressed to the SBRCG. Take care not to crumple or damage the ballot. And step 5, write your full name clearly and affix your signature in the space provided on the upper left portion of the ballot envelope, which is here. Seal the ballot envelope using the self-adhesive tape found on the flap. This here. This is the self-adhesive tape. So you have to take out this one, and when you're already filled out the form, you have to put inside this envelope, and you have to take off this soft adhesive tape, and you have to close it. So you cannot open it back, because if it will damage, then I think the SBRCG will not count your vote. And step 7, send back the ballot envelope early to ensure that it will be received by the SBRCG before 9 of May 2022 at 7 p.m. Philippine time. You may also personally drop the ballot envelope in the designated drop box at the address indicated on the envelope before the stated date and time. For proper voting from isang palala para sa wastong pagboto mula sa Commission on Election, Department of Foreign Affairs.
So, it's ready! So, nablaki na natin ang form na to. So, let's put here. So, I will not show you. And we will seal it.
So that's it. So let's vote wisely. Huwag po magpapadala sa pera dahil ang vote natin is para sa ikakaunlad ng Pilipinas. Ciao!